This month, we're asking for your support through our premium programs via the Escapist Plus and YouTube memberships. Your support allows us to continue making the content we want instead of chasing algorithms or the latest trends. Plus, you get a bunch of perks like ad-free viewing via the Escapist Plus on our website, early access on YouTube via YouTube memberships, and bonus content like our monthly Ask the Creators video series where we answer your burning questions. We've also added three new perks to our $5 tier, including a 15% discount on merch via our Teespring shop, a new piece of bonus content called Escapist Highlights featuring the best moments from our streams each month, and a new members-only livestream, The State of the Escapist, where you'll get a quarterly update on how the site is doing from our editor-in-chief. New merch is also available for Adventurers Nigh, Zero Punctuation, and more. Thanks to your continued support, The Escapist is on track for our best year yet. Amidst the doom and gloom that seems to perpetually surround the biggest of the big AAA video game developers and publishers, there is a silver lining. Look past legitimate concerns of annualization, microtransactions, and crunch-fueled burnout, and you have thousands upon thousands of immensely talented individuals who want nothing more than to create new worlds and forge powerful experiences. And sometimes, those creative people use their time, training, and resources at these titanic companies as a springboard to jump off and start something new and exciting, free from the burdens that come from such massive developers and publishers. Now, this is certainly nothing new. Hades developer Supergiant formed after its founders left their jobs at EA working on the Command & Conquer series. Night School Studio, the folks behind the wonderful Oxenfree, was created following departures from Telltale and Disney. And way back when, Psychonauts developer Double Fine was born when Tim Schafer and a handful of other colleagues at LucasArts left to pursue their own dreams. The constant ebb and flow in the AAA space means that there's always a migration of talent towards newer, smaller, and more exciting teams. Here are 13 newer studios that you might not know now, but whose pedigree, upcoming projects, and potential make them worth keeping an eye on. PlayStation has been busy in 2021. Aside from the launch of the PS5 and a consistent tick of stellar new releases, they announced partnerships with a pair of new independent studios. The first is the Montreal-based Haven, helmed by CEO and founder Jade Raymond, best known for her time at Ubisoft during the early days of the Assassin's Creed franchise. We know Haven's first game is a PS5 exclusive, and rumors point to it being an online games-as-a-service project, which seems to fill a gap in Sony's portfolio. Sony's partnership didn't stop at Haven. Next came the formation of Firewalk Studios, whom Sony has a publishing partnership with in regards to their first game, a brand new multiplayer IP. The founder's pedigree comes from massive games like Destiny, BioShock Infinite, Guitar Hero 2, Mass Effect, and Apex Legends. Given that both studios were formally announced earlier this year, don't expect their Sony games to be coming anytime soon, and once they do arrive, it's a safe bet that they'll be PS5 exclusives. Striking Distance was founded in 2019 by a group of industry veterans, including Glenn Schofield, best known for his time as the general manager of Sledgehammer Games on numerous Call of Duty games. But prior to Sledgehammer, he was the VP and general manager at Visceral Games, helping to create the iconic Dead Space franchise. Which is fitting, because the new studio's first project, a game set in the PUBG universe titled The Callisto Protocol, looks to be a spiritual successor to the sci-fi body horror classic in everything but name. Which is ironic, considering that we're now getting a proper Dead Space reboot from the folks at EA Motive. Gravity Well is a brand new LA-based AAA studio founded by Respawn alumni Drew McCoy and John Shiring. Their resume pretty much tracks the evolution of the first-person shooter over the past 15 years, including the first two Modern Warfare games, Apex Legends, and both Titanfalls. Or Titans? Titans Fall? Whatever. Their goal is pretty simple, to keep making the kinds of games that the team actually wants to play after the workday is over. Interestingly enough, Gravity Well almost feels like a second-generation studio, given the amount of talent that came over from Respawn, which itself was founded from a group who left Infinity Ward. Huh, I guess time is a flat circle. While a lot of studios on this list are in their relative infancy, there are a few who are much closer to releasing their freshman projects. First up is Stray Bombay, a group formed by Kimberly Vole, an expert on AI and human-centric design in her former role as principal technical game designer at Riot, and Chet Falasek, a longtime writer at Valve, best known for his work on Half-Life, Portal, and Left 4 Dead. That last one is key, given that the team's inaugural game, The Anacrusis, is a retro-futuristic 4-player co-op shooter set to debut later this fall. The Anacrusis is coming to PC and Xbox, and will be a part of Xbox Game Pass. Another team quite far along in development is Wolfeye Studios, a lean 25-person crew made up of many former Arkane developers who worked on Dishonored, Prey, and Arx Fatalis. Wolfeye's first game is Weird West. In a nutshell, Weird West takes the sandbox decision-making of immersive sims like Dishonored, adds in a pulpy western setting, and douses the whole thing in a canister of the macabre, resulting in what's shaping up to be a really neat experience. I covered Weird West much more thoroughly in a recent video preview, so check that out if you haven't. While most of these fresh studios trace their lineage back to some of the biggest western developers, this trend is happening all over the world. Case in point, Bokeh Game Studio, a team in Tokyo formed from a handful of ex-PlayStation veterans, born from the ashes of the now-shuttered Japan studio. This includes Silent Hill, Siren, and Gravity Rush creator Keiichiro Toyama. Though survival horror chops are going to come in handy, as their new project looks to be something nice and spooky, while also being influenced by the works of iconic film director Wong Kar-wai, which, to be honest, sounds lovely to me. Their first game is currently set for a 2023 release, which is probably about the time we'll be seeing a lot of games from developers on this list. Running through a list of Mountaintop Studios' pedigree feels akin to naming the first dozen game developers you can think of off the top of your head. This includes folks who've worked at Epic, Blizzard, Naughty Dog, Respawn, Infinity Ward, Ubisoft, Raven, Turtle Rock, Double Fine, PopCap, and Oculus. Phew, that's a long list. Mountaintop is ramping up production on their first game, a PvP-centric shooter that they say is inspired by some of their all-time favorites of the genre. Interestingly enough, Mountaintop is a remote-first studio, and as we're currently witnessing how much the pandemic continues to impact the gaming industry at large, it feels like a smart, future-proof decision. Embark Studios is a Stockholm-based team on a mission to blur the lines between playing and making. The team is composed of a lot of folks formerly of EA Dice, the developer behind Mirror's Edge, Battlefield, and Battlefront. While they're already working on a pair of projects, one being a cooperative free-to-play action game, the other a team-based PvP shooter, their goal is also much bigger than that. They want to help make game creation as easy as starting a blog or making music on your own. This includes making as many of their own development tools as open source as possible, and helping foster a collaborative, creative community. After working on Bioshock and Bioshock Infinite for the better part of a decade, Irrational Games effectively shuttered back in the old days of 2014. But from those ashes came Ghost Story Games, a much smaller studio still led by Ken Levine. The team's focus is not only on smaller, more replayable narrative games, but also changing the way stories are told through the interactive medium. It's been quite a while since we've had any update on their first project, which we last heard was an immersive, story-driven first-person science fiction adventure. But given how groundbreaking Bioshock was and still remains, it's worth waiting to see what this new team has in store. The most recently announced studio on this list is Raccoon Logic, a Montreal-based team of AAA developers, 75% of whom were working together at Typhoon Games under the Google umbrella. But with Google shutting down their internal Stadia teams, Typhoon was disbanded. But the team got back together, managed to acquire the rights to their excellent 2020 game Journey to the Savage Planet back from Google, and got investment for their next project from Tencent. While we don't know whether it's going to be a sequel or something new entirely, the team of former Ubisoft, Warner Brothers, and EA vets promised that they want to continue building in the colorful and humorous Monty Python-esque style and sensibility that made Savage Planet such a delight. Archetype Entertainment is an Austin-based studio that was established as a video game division of RPG and CCG publisher Wizards of the Coast. What makes Archetype feel special is the number of folks it's brought on, formerly of BioWare, who worked on certifiable classics like Baldur's Gate, Knights of the Old Republic, and the original Mass Effect, including the lead writer of the latter two. That's not counting other talent from Naughty Dog, 343, id Software, Sony Santa Monica, and more. Most recently, Archetype partnered with the cinematics maestros at Blur Studio for their first project, an ambitious sci-fi RPG set in a brand new universe. And finally, we have That's No Moon, a studio formed from a veteran team of folks from Naughty Dog and Infinity Ward. They partnered with South Korea's Smilegate, the group behind the mega-popular multiplayer Crossfire franchise, which provided $100 million for its startup and first project. Their mission is to focus on single-player, story-driven games, which is a great thing to hear. We need more of those kinds of studios. Also, the team's name being a clear nod to Star Wars has us wondering if they'll be dabbling in a galaxy far, far away. These are just a small taste of the many, many independent teams that have formed from the orbit of massive AAA studios. It might be a while before we see a lot of their games, but good things come to those who wait. And though this might be the first time you've heard of their names, it almost certainly will not be the last.